Hey guys, welcome to all of you on our channel, that is Achieve IAS. So friends, as you know that on our channel we are targeting the exam of civil services, and for that purpose we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So in this video we will be talking about our current affair based MCQ series, in which what we do, we daily discuss your 10 MCQs relating to the current affairs of the day. So today is 20th August, so let's discuss what are the MCQs of today. So the first question is, consider the following groupings and their intended objectives. First, basic, to act jointly on climate change and emission reduction. Second, G4, its objective to promote its members' collective economic interest and create an enhanced joint negotiating capacity in United Nations. Third is P5, to secure global peace and security. Fourth is G77, objective is support each other's bids for permanent seat on the United Nations Security Council. So we have to choose that which of the above is not correctly matched. So please note the word not correctly. Let me tell you friends that basic is, yes, basic is correct. It is correctly matched. It is basically Brazil, South Africa, India and China. So these are the countries that are newly industrialized and they have decided to act jointly on climate change and emission reduction issues. So first is correctly matched, G4 second is incorrect, because G4 is a grouping of India, Japan, Germany and Brazil, which support each other bid for permanent seat in Security Council. So second is incorrectly matched, third is correct. P5 is basically to secure global peace and security, so they are the permanent members of United Nations Security Council. And G77 is incorrectly matched, because it's basically a grouping of developing countries to basically to promote its members collective economic interests and create an enhanced joint negotiating capacity in United Nations. So which of the above are incorrectly matched? So your second and fourth are incorrectly matched. So the answer would be B, that is 2 and 4. So as I've told you already, explanation has been given to you. Basic countries, they work for promotion of they are basically newly industrialized countries to act jointly on climate change and emission reduction issues. G4, as I've told you, to secure the permanent seat, and G77 to secure economic interest, and P5 is permanent membership. And second question is, consider the following statements related to legislative council present in the states. First, it is permanent chamber available in the state. Second, parliament under Article 169 has the power to create or abolish the second chamber of the states. Third, all states of Indian Union has a permanent legislative council present in it. Fourth is, the constitution needs amendment under Article 368 to create or abolish the legislative council in the states. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. So you might be confused in this question, because friends, first is correct. You can say that how permanent chamber is available in states. Actually, it is basically relating to the tenure. So yes, to every state the option is open, the option of a permanent legislative council is open. As you know that legislative council, that is Vidhan Parishad, doesn't dissolute like the Rajya Sabha. So yes, it is the permanent chamber available to states, and first is correct, and second is also correct, because parliament under Article 169 has the power to create or abolish second chamber of the states. And third is not correct, because only 7 states have permanent legislative council. And your fourth is also incorrect. So any if the parliament, for example, provides for the creation of legislative council, then that doesn't mean that it will not be counted as amendment under Article 368. So first and two are correct, 1 and 2 are correct, so B is correct answer. So here is the explanation. So there is no point to go into deep of these things. You can read them on the while we will provide you the PDF. So these are the details. Let's move on to the third question. Third question is, consider the following terrorist organization and their location. First, ISIS Afghanistan. Second, Boko Haram India. Third, Jaish-e-Mohammed Pakistan. Fourth, Simi Nigeria. So here we have to choose that which of the following above pair is correctly matched. Let me tell you friends that yes, first is correct, Islamic State of Iraq and Levant. Khurasan province is basically based in Afghanistan. But second is correct because Boko Haram is not in India, but it is in Nigeria. So which is a basically Islamist terrorist organization that aims to promote Sharia law in Nigeria. So second is incorrect. Third is correct. Yes, Jaish-e-Mohammed is Pakistan-based terrorist organization that carries its operations in Kashmir. So fourth is incorrect because this SIMI is basically the organization in India. So which of the above pair is correctly matched? So first and third is correctly matched. So the answer would be B. So as already I've told you that basically this Boko Haram is in Nigeria and it aims to institute Sharia. And then you are students of Islamic Movement of India. It is basically it is a banned terrorist organization in India. So it is a banned Islamist organization that was formed in Aligarh in UP in April 1977, with the stated mission of liberation of India from Western materialistic cultural influence and to convert its Muslim society to live according to the Muslim code of conduct. So your fourth question is, which of the following statements is right? First, Gibraltar is a British overseas territory located on the south coast of Spain. Second, it opens to the Atlantic Ocean to its east. So friends, you might be confused in this question. The first statement is correct. Yes, Gibraltar is a British overseas territory and it lies in the south coast of Spain. But second statement is not correct, but because yes, it opens into Atlantic Ocean, but not to its east, but to its west. So the answer that would be is A. That is one only. So you can see the map here. So here this is Gibraltar. So you can see Gibraltar at the south coast of your Spain, and it is British overseas territory and it opens into Atlantic Ocean to its west. So this answer, as you might have been able to comprehend. Let's move on to the next question. Fifth question is, the draft witness protection scheme which was approved by the Supreme Court 2018 contains which of the following provisions? First, protection of witness identity. Second, witness protection fund. Third, relocation of witness who is under threat or intimidation. So which of the above statements is correct? So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. Let me tell you friends that all of these statements are correct because basically draft witness protection scheme, it has been drafted by central government with the assistance of NALSA, that is National Legal Services Authority, so which aims to protect the witness from the intimidation by establishing witness protection fund, as well as relocation of witness and its family members if the witness is under threat, and also protection of witness identity. So the purpose of this scheme is to ensure free and fair justice, as well as free and fair we can say criminal justice system, apart from ensuring that this law enforcement takes place. So answer is D, that is 1, 2, and 3. So already I have provided you the details. So when Supreme Court in the Premchand versus State of NCT of Delhi directed the respective state governments to implement this draft witness protection scheme. So already as I've told you that objective is to promote law enforcement as well as to identify series of measures in which we can protect the witness and its family members, including their lives, reputation and property. Let's move on to the sixth question. Sixth question is, which of the following is the tuberculosis control strategy followed by the Indian government? A, directly observed treatment short courses. B, antiretroviral therapy. C, antibiotic treatment. D, none of the above. So here we have to choose the correct answer. So let me tell you friends that the correct answer is A, that is DOTS. So TB DOTS, basically this treatment is the best curative treatment recommended by the World Health Organization, that is directly observed treatment short course. So answer is A. So DOTS is basically, it is the best control strategy recommended by World Health Organization. So it has five main components, that is government commitment. So government including the political will at all the levels with the establishment of a centralized and prioritized system of TB monitoring, recording and training, and then case detection by sputum smears, your microscopy, and then standardized treatment regimen, and then drug supply, and then a standardized recording and reporting system that allows assessment of treatment results. Let's move on to the next question. Next question is, which of the following is are correctly matched? So here, award to Prime Minister, so country. So if one Grand Collar Palestine, second Order of St. Andrew Russia, third Amir Amanullah Khan Award Afghanistan, fourth Zayed Medal Saudi Arabia. So we have to choose the correct answer. So let me tell you friends that the first is correct. Grand Collar is the highest civilian award of Palestine, which was given to our Prime Minister in 2018. And Order of St. Andrew Award is the highest civilian award of Russia. And Amir Amanullah Khan Award is the highest award of Afghanistan, but fourth is not correct because Zayed Medal is the highest civilian award of United Arab Emirates. So the answer would be 1, 2, and 3. So A would be the answer. So this Zayed Medal is basically of UAE, and this of the Saudi Arabia is your this highest civilian order, firstly of Afghanistan Amir Amanullah Khan Award, and secondly of Saudi Arabia, the King Abdul Aziz Shas was conferred to PM Modi in 2016. So these are the details. Let's move to the next question. Next question is, consider the following statements related to Chilka Lake ecosystem. So first is, it is the largest brackish water lagoon in India, located on the west coast of India. Second, it is the largest wintering ground in India. So here you might be confused. Third is, it was designated as the first Indian wetland of international importance under Ramsar Convention. Fourth, it is home to Irrawaddy dolphins. So here friends, you might be confused that though this is the largest brackish water lagoon, but let me tell you that it is located on the east coast and not the west coast. So this is the minute these are the minute details which you must keep in mind while attempting your exam. So first statement is incorrect, second is correct, that is, it is the largest wintering ground for the migratory waterfall, and also it was designated as first site under Ramsar Convention, and it is also home to Irrawaddy dolphins, which is listed as endangered under IUCN Red List. So the answer would be second, third, and fourth. So the answer would be D. So Chilka Lake is basically marine brackish and freshwater ecosystem located on the east coast, and it is shallow lagoon and largest lagoon in India and largest wintering ground for migratory waterfowl, and it is located in Puri, Khurda, and Ganjam district of Odisha, and fed by 52 rivers and rivulets. And there is also Nalabana Island, that is forest of reeds, which was declared bird sanctuary in 1987, and the protection status is that migratory birds like waterfowl, they are protected under Wildlife Protection Act 1972, and also it is first designated Ramsar site in India, and also it is home to Irrawaddy dolphin, which is listed as endangered under IUCN, and it was the first lake in India to be listed under Montreux Record, and also it was removed from Montreux Record in 2002 due to the successful restoration of Chilka Development Authority by the Chilka Development Authority. So it was the first site to be removed from Montreux Record. And next, your ninth question is, which of the following are the principles of Indian nuclear doctrine? First is first use policy, second credible minimum deterrence, third massive second strike capability, fourth exporting nuclear weapons to friendly countries. So here friends, let me tell you that it is an easy question. First is clearly wrong because India has the two main principles, that is no first use policy and credible minimum deterrence. And then if in case if any country uses against India its nuclear weapons or chemical or biological weapons, and the credible minimum deterrence fails, then India has clear India has clear doctrine that it will undertake massive second strike capability that would cause the maximum destruction in the country that has first attacked it. So the answer would be your second and third. So B would be the answer. So here is the explanation. So two main things are no first use policy. So it ensures credible minimum deterrence, as India says that it retains the right of massive scale, or basically to cause massive destruction to the enemy country that used nuclear weapons against India. So it is based on staggering and punitive retaliation in case of deterrence failure. Next is 10th question. 10th question is, consider the following statements related to space technologies. First, Parker Solar Probe is a joint initiative of NASA and European Space Agency. Second, the probe seeks to gather information about the sun's atmosphere. So we have to choose that which of the above statements is correct. Let me tell you friends that the first statement is incorrect because Parker Solar Probe is the is an endeavor of this NASA and not of European Space Agency. They are not collaborating. It is the initiative is solely undertaken by NASA. and it basically seeks to gather the information about sun's atmosphere. So the answer would be B, that is second only. So here is the explanation, so you can pause and can see it if you are interested in seeing it. And these are the three detailed scientific objectives, that is trace flow of energy that heats and accelerates the solar corona and solar wind, and determine the structure and dynamics of the plasma and the magnetic fields at the sources of the solar wind, and explore mechanisms that accelerate and transport energetic particles. So this is all about, friends, today's video. If you like the questions, if you like the video, then do ensure that you like it, share it with your friends. And lastly, friends, if in case you are interested to join to get the PDF of these MCQs, then you can contact us at our contact number, that is 8968920720. You can also mail us at achieveies21@gmail.com, or simply you can join our initiative by using the link that will be given in the description box. So it is certainly paid subscription. If in case you are interested to get the MCQs, then you will the PDF of the MCQs, then you will have to just pay amount of 99 rupees per month. So it is minimum amount that we have kept for the purpose of your affordability and for the purpose of our motivation. So if in case you are interested, do ensure that you check the description box, and again, and can by using the link there, you can join our initiative. And lastly, friends, we also have a website, that is www.achieveies.co.in, in which what we do, we upload important articles of daily relevance. So you can visit our website and can also join our Telegram channel, the link of which is shown on your screen. So this is all about today's video. Thank you. Have a very nice day ahead, and also ensure that you subscribe to our channel. So thank you. Have a very nice day ahead. Thank you.